So, today I'm going to talk a little bit about what's happening next week. Obviously, the independence referendum, a couple of sad deaths to report, and a little bit of look about WWE's NXT Takeover Fatal 4-Way, which is happening tonight, and a little bit of information about how the UK fans can actually view this event. Well, firstly, obviously, today is the 11th of September. The 13th anniversary of the 9/11 terrorist attacks in the United States of America. Now, as some people may have seen on my YouTube channel, I was actually in New York City this week last year. Visited the site of the Twin Towers, witnessed the building of which is it's now open, I believe. The 9/11 museum. There was actually a museum like a little bit off-site with a lot of pictures, photographs, bits and pieces from the tragedy in New York City on display. It's a very haunting and very it's just an amazing place to visit. So I would thoroughly recommend visiting if you're in New York City. It's certainly somewhere that I think you need to go if you truly do wish to pay your respects to all those people who lost their lives on this day in 2001. So again, my condolences to all the family, the friends, all those still suffering with the memories of what happened on that terrible day. Certainly, it's a day of all today of all days to remember all those involved on 9/11. Now, a quick couple of sad deaths to report. Firstly, the actor Richard Keel, best known for playing the Steel Tooth Jaws in the James Bond films, passed away at the age of 74. He died in a hospital in Fresno, California, and the news was announced earlier today. Very sad. He's a very nice gentleman, apparently, according to many people who knew him. Sad to hear of his passing. He was actually part of a BBC Radio 4 program called The Reunion alongside Sir Roger Moore and Britt Ekland, which aired apparently this past Sunday, so I'll have to check that out on the BBC iPlayer radio section, see whether it's still available. I'm really interested in, I didn't realize that was actually on this week. I wasn't sure when it was going to be on, as I'd heard that they were going to film it. And Roger Moore has been obviously paying tribute to his friend there. He was a great ambassador for the James Bond films later in life. Again, so sad to hear about his passing, so my sincere condolences to his friends and family. Also, my sincere condolences to the friends and family of Sean Christopher Hare, known to professional wrestling fans as Sean O'Hare. He wrestled in both WCW World Championship Wrestling and WWE from 2001 to 2004. After he left WWE, he was a mixed martial artist. He was also a personal fitness coach and I believe a hairstylist, perhaps at the time of his passing. Police have reported this morning, or so this morning when it comes to UK time, as suicide, which is so tragic. We've had couple of celebrities passing away, and a couple of, including a couple committing suicide this last about 3 weeks or so. So it's very sad. My sincere condolences to his friends and family as well at this sad time. Now, obviously, said today is the 11th September. It actually is quite a good anniversary as well of something completely different. It is the 17th anniversary of the Scottish Devolution Referendum. On the 11th of September 1997, the Scottish people voted overwhelmingly for devolution, which led to the re-establishment of the Scottish Parliament after nearly 300 years. Now, obviously, it is next week, Thursday, the 18th of September, that the Scottish people will be going once more and voting on a referendum, and that is the Scottish Independence Referendum. Should Scotland be an independent country? Now, I've made my views on this perfectly clear. I am pro-independence. I am pro-yes vote. I hope really hope that Scotland will vote yes and move towards independence, which, if voted for, will occur on the 24th of March 2016. So that's all going to happen next week. Probably this will maybe the last mention of independence referendum on this YouTube channel, simply because I don't know what the laws are, because I know there are several laws regarding what you can say, what you cannot say on publicly on forums such as YouTube in the immediate run-up to the referendum, which I'm not a lawyer. I don't know what exactly the laws are, but I've looked up a couple of things and it looks a bit dodgy. I don't want to get myself into legal trouble. I'm not, and I mean my viewpoint's clear, and I'm not forcing anybody to vote any particular way. I disagree if you looked at the evidence and you have come to the decision and you wish to vote no. I respect that. I don't agree with it, but I certainly respect that. If you wish to vote no, that's fully up to yourself. It's up to each individual, however way they wish to vote on this referendum. It's entirely up to them. I disagree. Honestly, I disagree. If you wish to vote no, but again, that is entirely up to each individual person. And I have to say, it's a great. There's been a great reaction to the registering to vote for this referendum. It closed on September 3rd, so you cannot now actually register to vote in this referendum. I believe you may be able to still register to vote, but you would not be eligible to be voting in this referendum. Now, at the last, I think it's called the census. When you put down it, like every 10 years, you write down the who lives in your house, what their name is, their ages. You obviously it's a legal thing you cannot lie on. So you put down, you write down the details of who lives in your house. I believe certainly from the census and from the educated guesses that. That the people have made that the population of Scotland is just over 5.3 million people. Obviously, there's room. Obviously, it's just for 5.32 million, 5.32 odd million people in Scotland. That is the population, according to the Electoral Commission. This is actually good, considering a couple of facts here, though. Firstly, that many people were already registered to vote, like myself, my family, they're already registered to vote. And considering the amount, obviously, there's children, there's under 16, so 16, you have to be 16 years old, obviously, to vote in this referendum. Considering these facts, it's a tremendous amount that are actually registered to vote, that are eligible to vote in this referendum. The Electoral Commission has revealed that, according to their figures, 4,285,323 people are registered to vote in this referendum. So hopefully a lot of people of the vast majority, overwhelmingly vast majority of this 4,285,323 people will actually vote in this referendum. Again, I'm behind the pro-independence campaign. I'm pro-yes. I wish Scotland to go independent. It is absolutely, I am absolutely hoping that the vast majority of these people actually go ahead and vote. So there's certainly been a tremendous response. Like you said, considering there was a lot of people already registered to vote, but there's been a tremendous upsurge in the amount of people registering to vote before this, before September 3rd, when the registration cut-off was. I genuinely hope a lot of the people do actually take the time, take the opportunity to vote next Thursday, September 18th. As I said, I do not know what the laws are regarding what I can say, what I cannot say. I'll film myself on my camera the day before. As I said, this will possibly be the last mention of the referendum on this channel because I don't want to get myself in legal trouble. I don't want to get myself any strikes against me on YouTube. But so I will film myself on my camera, speak about what's going on the day before, the day of the voting next week, next Thursday, September 18th, and then once the result is known, what I think of it, and then obviously as the hours and the maybe the day or so goes on, what the general reaction to whatever the result is, I'll upload the video once I've edited it. Probably obviously near the end of the month, probably round about the 23rd, 24th, or 25th of September. Once I think, yep, that's enough film, you know, that's okay, and that once I've edited it together, I will upload it to YouTube so you can get a feel, a genuine look at what I feel has been going on around. Obviously, both the campaigns going out and trying to convince the people in one last surge. Apparently, a couple of the people in Dundee today, I won't be able to make it to town obviously today, but certainly I'll be going down and look at seeing what well certainly we've seen what the reaction is from the Scottish people in the newspapers and the online websites, and hearing what's on the news, and then I'll go give it a bit of a roundup after the result. Whatever, obviously, regarding whatever the result is, it will affect the people of Scotland tremendously. So, like I said, I'm pro-independence, I am pro-yes. If you have looked at the evidence and you wish to vote no and you are voting no, I tremendously disagree with you. But again, I respect that your viewpoint if you have that viewpoint. I respect it, I disagree with it, but I respect it. But I'll certainly be looking at very seriously whatever the result is next week. The day of voting is a single day of voting next Thursday, September 18th. So I'm estimating that we will probably know the result round about the possibly the early hours of the 20th of September. Possibly sometime during the 20th or the 21st, because I don't know. I'm guess from what all the indications are, the opinion polls, the polling stations actually are open from 7 a.m. to 10 p.m. on the 18th. So that is when the voting will occur. And I believe, just like normally here in the UK during the general election or a by-election or whatever, the votes are normally counted as soon as possible after the polls have closed. So it's pretty much immediately that as soon as they can, obviously transfer the boxes containing the votes to the counting stations. They are normally processed immediately. So I'm guessing we will know possibly within the early hours of the 19th, certainly by the 20th. Of September, I think the result should be made official. Not entirely sure what the out the timeline is. The outline of the, obviously for security reasons, they have said that the votes will be. It seems to be that the votes will be counted immediately. Obviously, due to security concerns and these days, obviously they have not said an exact absolute timeline. We will probably get that information next week. We'll probably get that information regarding exactly when we can expect an official result. Probably the day prior to the poll. That's normally what it happens. Some people will probably claim, well, we know what's happening already, but officially from the official administrators, there's never an official statement regarding exactly what's going to happen until about the day or the day before or the day before. The penultimate day before voting is normally when they would come out with the official absolute statements regarding when the voting. But I'm assuming, looking at what I could find online, the votes will be counted pretty much immediately. Obviously, with it being such an important vote, and such a nationwide vote in Scotland. Obviously, there will be checking of the vote, so it will take some hours. It will not be a case of the polls close at 10 p.m. on the 18th, and we will know the result by midnight. Absolutely no chance of that. At least the early hours of the 19th of September is when we will know the official results, at least regarding the Scottish independence referendum. Depending on what I'm doing, I will certainly be keeping up, staying awake to see what, obviously, because there's going to be huge news specials on all the channels regarding the latest on the voting, what the opinion polls are saying. Some people, some opinion polls are taken outside polling stations. Okay, what, asking people what they have just voted, which is perfectly legal, but sometimes it can be annoying. You get somebody outside asking you what you voted when you, obviously, it's up to you whether you want to discuss it with them or not, but certainly, the early hours of the 19th of September, at least until we know the official result. As I said, I think it will be a slightly longer, perhaps something during the day on the 19th of September, we will know the result officially. But as I said, I'll put up the video regarding regarding the whole process in the few days when I can. So I'm really actually looking forward to it. It's going to be a momentous decision, one of the biggest decisions Scottish people will ever take. If it's a yes, obviously we know a little bit what's happening, but there's still, unknowns on both sides. But again, I'm really looking forward to next Thursday, 18th September, casting my vote for yes in the Scottish independence referendum. And honestly, genuinely, I never thought that I would see this day. I thought perhaps maybe one day when I'm really old and infirm, we may see an independence referendum, but to have it now, it's going to be tremendous. And obviously, regardless of whatever anybody's thoughts on that video when it appears, as you know, obviously you can tell, I'm born in Scotland, live in Scotland. I am Scottish, so this will affect me. Regardless, even if I was living in Canada, New Zealand, Australia, the Antarctic, wherever. Wherever I happen to be living at this particular time, I am Scottish, so obviously this will affect me, affect my country, so it will obviously continue to be talked about on this YouTube channel. Now, before I go on, quickly talk about WWE's NXT Takeover Fatal 4-Way, which is happening tonight. I believe, checking my listings on the Sky EPG Electronic Programming Guide, you can certainly see it. I believe the program synopsis, the description, is not available, but I believe from what I read that it will be, they will be showing tonight's NXT TakeOver Fatal 4-Way on Sky Sports 3 this coming Saturday at 11:30 p.m. So we will see what happens tonight in WWE's NXT TakeOver Fatal 4-Way. Now, there are five matches made for this event. There is Mojo Rawley versus Bull Dempsey. There's a hair versus hair match between Enzo Amore and Sylvester Lefort. The Ascension, Connor and Victor, will defend the NXT Tag Team Championship against Kalisto and Sin Cara. Charlotte will defend her NXT Women's Championship against Bayley. Now, there will also be the introduction, and it will not be a match, I believe it will not be a match, of Kenta by the Nature Boy Ric Flair. I seriously don't think, I would love it to be, but I don't think this will be a match. I think this will be a general introduction to WWE NXT for Kenta. Obviously, they're relying on a lot of the WWE fans to watch NXT, which some of them do. It's on, it's going to be, this program is going to be live on the WWE Network as part of their subscription for $9.99. I'm really looking forward to just to seeing him introduced, and hopefully we may actually hear when he will be making his in-ring debut. And also, the main event for the NXT Championship, a Fatal 4-Way Tyson Kidd versus Tyler Breeze versus Sami Zayn versus the NXT champion Adrian Neville. This should be a really good match. Fatal 4-way match, which obviously means first person to gain a pinfall or a submission wins the match and gains or retains the NXT championship. So I'm really looking forward to this show. Looking forward to watching it. It should be a tremendous show. Obviously, it's going to be a little bit annoying because it'll be cut up a little bit by adverts, but it's expected to be around about a 2-hour show, possibly a bit longer, depending on the way Sky Sports show it. Probably it will be with adverts, but it should be cut to the point where there is adverts in between segments, so we don't miss anything, because also it'll be recorded at that point on Saturday on Sky Sports 3, 11:30 p.m. WWE NXT, which is their developmental system, Takeover, Fatal 4-Way. Really looking forward to that, to watching that show. It's going to be a lot of fun. So again, I'm not going to too long, but actually looking forward to seeing what happens next week. Obviously, I said the referendum. I'll keep up to date. There shouldn't be any major changes, any major news information regarding the referendum that's happening next week at this point. All is set to go. There should be no problems. There's no issues, certainly regarding the referendum going ahead at this point. According to the Electoral Commission, again, they reported earlier today or last night, whenever it came out, I'm not entirely sure, but certainly sometime late last night, early this morning, because it appeared on my newsfeed today that certainly didn't happen yesterday. Everything is a go for the independence referendum. It's all set to take place. It seems all the arrangements have been made. Everything is okay. So, it's genuinely a little bit, admittedly, I'm getting a little bit nervous about it. Not nervous about going to vote. I know where I'm going to vote. Obviously, I said before on how to vote, stick to attending the polling station on your voter's card, which you should have got, which is, I'll just show you once again before I go, your Scottish Independence Referendum official poll card. That will tell you where to go in that box there. That is the address which you must attend. That is the only address that you can attend in order to cast your vote in the independence referendum. You cannot just choose to go to, I don't want to go to primary school, I'll go to the library, I'll go to the city centre, and I'll go to one there while I'm at work. You must go to the polling station written on your independence referendum official poll card, because that area, that place that you will be able to and only able to cast your vote there. So it's looking good, it's looking everything, it's going well. It looks like all the arrangements have been made. Obviously, I'm not part of doing anything officially, which is a little bit annoying, but certainly it's going to be exciting to see what this last few days brings up, and also I'll talk about that on the video as well. But certainly keep an eye on this channel, and I will bring you up a roundup of what has happened with the Scottish independence referendum near the end of the month after the official result is. Honestly, I would say regardless of where you are in the world, regardless of whatever your views are, like I said, if you're wanting to vote no, I disagree, but I completely respect your opinion. If you have genuinely taken the time to look at the evidence and that is the way your mind has been made up, I respect that. I disagree with it, but I respect it. And I have to say, before I go, it is an absolute boom, and it is absolute credit to the Scottish people that we have reached this stage where we are going to an independence referendum with no bloodshed, no violence, no acts of terror, no acts of public unruliness, not anything like that. We are going to the polls and we are doing it the right and proper way. We are doing it with our vote. We are doing it with our feet instead of our fists. And again, I genuinely hope that we are going to vote yes. We are going to be vote pro-independence, because as I think it was perhaps Gandhi or somebody certainly said, It is better to die on your feet than live on your knees. And in my opinion, that is exactly what the Scottish people need to do. We need to stand on our own two